We talk about the crime crisis, drugs, property theft, murders, but it's not just an Albuquerque problem. A new documentary has taken a bold approach to similar issues in a northern New Mexico community.
According to federal statistics, Española consistently ranks among the top in the nation in drug overdoses.
Our Brittany Costello joins me now. And Brittany, the mayor of Española is behind a new documentary shedding light on some of those problems like drug use.
Yeah, and it's really difficult to hear, especially if you're from there. But the mayor says the only way to inspire change is to expose the problem so people can come together to find a solution.
For most of us, it's just part of a scenic drive, a pass-through community just outside of Santa Fe.
We're at the heart of northern New Mexico, but our heart is broken.
Española hasn't changed much over the years, still a beautiful mountainous community, but its reputation has.
Statistically, Española has the worst violence, the highest crime rate, and the highest drug use rate in the state of New Mexico.
It's not about pride. Mayor Javier Sanchez says he has plenty of it.
In a lot of ways, Española has been written off, considered too far gone to be repaired.
That's exactly why he's working with the Desert Gold Group on a documentary, A Truth, the community our state leaders can no longer ignore.
I became addicted to cocaine and heroin, and then in 2006, I lost everything because of the addiction. I lost my family, I lost my home, I lost my self-identity. I became homeless here in Española.
The stories of substance abuse are mirrored in statistics.
She gives us data on babies that are being born exposed to opioids. In 2016, and this is off my memory, but at the highest point, 80 babies were born exposed to opioids or addicted, however you want to look at it. Out of 290 plus births, that's almost one third of the births.
Mayor Sanchez says there are stores in town selling the most alcohol in the state. The same stores?
It ranks third when it comes to selling opioid drugs in the entire state of New Mexico. The first two are found in Albuquerque.
Wow. Well, that doesn't even add up, though.
It does not add up.
That's because Española has an estimated population of 10,000. Albuquerque, 560,000. Sanchez says it's about more than highlighting a community's darkest secrets.
To make everyone recognize that in order to improve, we have to recognize where we're from, and we have to sound that bell to get the recognition that we need.
It's a call for help.
When we look at economic development, what we need here is high-speed internet access that we just have not had in a very long time. What we need here is entrepreneurial spirit to be able to get a change in how we think.
And that's what this four-part series will detail, the problems and potential solutions. Sanchez says those solutions include a huge ask from the state.
We're asking for $43 million to help turn northern New Mexico around, because it's going to happen here in Española. All of that involves changes in infrastructure, investment in our education, investment in our safety, and in our youth empowerment.
He says they typically get anywhere from $500,000 to $1 million.
Now, there is a lot of ambition in this documentary, but it's also generating a lot of mixed reaction.
Yeah, we see a lot of comments here on Facebook. Let's look at Ben Sandoval here. He says, this beginning really makes our community look bad. He also goes on to say, we work so hard to give our youth a reason to want to stay here and create change.
Yeah, and there are many comments like that, but this is a four-part series, so they will also be highlighting the solutions. The second one came out today. We have a link to where you can watch that on KLB.com. You can just click on this story.
All right, Brittany, thank you very much.
Yeah.